Hey, this is Andrew Klein. This is the fourth video in our Principles of 3D Modeling video series. In the previous videos, we've taken a look at a couple of topics dealing with getting to understand Maya a little bit better. We've looked at creating primitive objects with polygons and NURBS. We've looked at adding geometry into these models, grouping parts of these models, inserting image planes, and a whole variety of other ideas. In this video, we're actually going to push the idea of what you can do with NURBS geometry a little bit further. The Creating a Toy video series looked at using primitive objects to make rough forms, but it's not a really advanced way of working with NURBS. What we're going to do today is we're going to create a bishop chess piece from a series of curves, eventually creating lofted parts and revolved parts, extruded parts, etc., to create a patchwork. And it's actually a process known as NURBS multi-patch modeling. With that completed model, essentially be a grouped together piece from several patches, hopefully maintaining surface tangency across our gaps. That's going to be a concept that we're going to examine in much more detail in a few minutes. Well, moving this to the side here, we're going to start off in Maya, and I'm actually going to start off by building the base of this first. To do that, I'm going to have to create some circular curves. Now for this tutorial, if you were in the polygon menu set, now would be a good time to switch to your surfaces menu set. For this today, I'm also going to be looking at the curves shelf tab and the surfaces shelf tab. But we're going to start off in the curves shelf. I'm going to choose a NURBS curve circle, which is going to create a circle on my ground plane. Now this is a curve. There's actually nothing here that's going to render. There's no geometry actually established on this model. What I'm going to do with this, however, is I'm going to take this curve, and I'll hit W for the Move tool, and I'm going to duplicate this curve, moving it up to create a sort of lathe silhouette for the model. So let me show you what I'm doing here, and I'm going to then cross-reference this with the actual bishop that we looked at a second ago. I'm going to take my curve and hit Control-D, which is the hotkey for duplicate, and I'm going to move this curve upwards. This is NURBS Circle 2. I'll hit Control-D again and move this up, hit R for the Scale tool, and take the yellow box and scale this in uniformly. I don't want to scale it in just one axis because that's going to break the sort of radial symmetry that this has. I'll hit Control-D and hit W for the Move tool. So that was Duplicate and then Move. And I'm going to move this up one more time. Then I'm going to take my larger curve just below, Circle 2, and hit Control-D. Move that one up just above this form. And duplicate just a few more, moving them up, scaling them together, till we have a good-looking form. I'm going to hit spacebar twice to go to my side view, and I actually think I can probably move some of these down a little bit to tighten this up. And then I want to show you what it is I'm exactly looking at here, based off of the bishop that we previously saw. Let me move these windows to the side. And let's compare this to the base of the bishop. By creating these NURBS circles, I'm essentially creating, as I said, a lathe silhouette. I'm going up this first section, and then if you notice, my circles get smaller as I scale them in. That's going to be this groove that's been cut into the base. The circle then gets bigger, coming outwards. That's going to be my rounded section, and then eventually going to flow upwards towards the top. And I actually look like I want to scale this one in just a little bit more. Now, we've created a sort of profile for this. And my next step in this process is going to be to create a loft. And what we're going to do is I'm going to select each one of these circles. Select one, and then I'll hold down Shift. And I'm going to work my way upwards. You have to make sure that you're going exactly upwards. So holding down Shift, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. You want to make sure you get these exactly in order, because we're essentially running up a ladder here. We're going to go up and loft around this form, and it's going to create a surface based entirely on these curves. I'm going to go to Surfaces. This is in the Surfaces menu set. There's a window called Surfaces. And I'm going to go to Loft and choose the Options box. Now, with this, I'm actually going to be able to loft into actually any different type of geometry I want. I can loft to NURBS, polygons, sub-Ds, Bezier curves even. We're going to leave this at NURBS, and I'm going to hit Apply. And we're in wireframe mode right now, but when I hit 5, you'll actually notice that I have a NURBS surface. It's in angular mode right now, so I'm going to hit 3, so it rounds out to its default curvature. And there we go. We have a lofted surface coming from curves. Now, what's interesting about this is that as long as there's history still active on the model, I can select these curves and actually tweak my proportions based on the curves. So if I want to get a little bit more of an actual roof shape to this, straighten this out, I can do so by selecting those curves. And I can choose exactly how steep or round I want this to be. Based on the image that I was referencing here, it actually is pretty round, so we'll see if we can preserve some of that. It also looks like I might want to bring this upper curve section back up a little bit more. So I'll select these. If you're having a hard time actually selecting the curves, you can use your selection masks on the upper bar, the status bar. If I turn off the Windows icon-looking logo, it's a little sort of waving flag, that's going to turn off my ability to actually select surfaces. And now I can just select curves. I'll make sure I turn that back on, though, because I do want to work with this. Now, as soon as I go in and go to Edit, Delete All by Type, History, the history of my object, the actual loft, is going to be removed. And if I select one of these curves now, such as here, you can see I can move the curve independently, and it's no longer going to affect the surface. You're actually going to want to do that. You're going to want to make sure you get rid of that history, because having that active causes, you know, extra memory issues, and every sort of piece that we tweak really has to go back through the calculation process of all of this as you're moving it. So we want to kind of cut that out if we can. I'm going to go into my hypergraph, window, hypergraph hierarchy, and see if I can actually organize this a little bit better as well. I've got all these NURBS circles, NURBS circle 1 through 8, which I'm going to select by dragging a selection over them or holding down Shift. And I'm going to group them. Control G. And this will give me a new group, which I'm going to rename Construction underscore Curves. I want to keep all of my curves while making this, just in case I have to rebuild something later on, like if I mess up a part of the actual model. It's going to be to my benefit to keep these around. But since I don't want to see them, I'm going to right-click, and I'm going to choose Hide, which is actually going to make them invisible in the viewport. Well, now I've just got lofted surface 1. Let's make a group for that. I'm going to hit Control-G, and I'm going to rename this group Bishop by right-clicking on it and choosing Rename. The lofted surface, this is the base of the chess piece. So I'm going to right-click on lofted surface and rename this Base. To me as well, it looks a little bit rounded, and we're going to work with that in just a bit. We've also got to make a bottom piece for this, and all of that's going to come up in our next video. So hold on, we'll be there in just a second.